Author Palak is now 25. I am here to share my experiences with you of how we brought Palak up. Yeah, day-to-day and simple methods. Now we have come to the conclusion that there were methods, but we just carried on in our own way. Our dream of having a baby child came to reality on 7th of July 1992. With wholehearted support from my in-laws, we, the five-man army, started walking hand in hand to give full attention to my daughter Palak. I am very happy-go-lucky type of person with tight compartments for workplace and home. As I am not controlling or demanding type, our home atmosphere is usually very light, healthy, refreshing and conducive. Palak's physiotherapies were solely my responsibilities. I am very good at chanting Sanskrit verses and my children used to recite them with me. That has helped Palak to speak with clarity. Even I am good at remembering people, their names. I have a good road sense too. I informed and told everything to Palak right from her childhood, whether she understood or not. But that created a good social quotient, good road sense, and good capability of memory. I escorted Palak daily to her school. That opened a breach of communication between me and her teacher. In first standard, her teacher once informed me that Palak used to tear off the pages of notebooks and she used to throw the pages in the whole class. The talks regarding discipline and cleanliness went in vain. Then I instructed her teacher to give task to Palak to clean the entire classroom at the end of the day. That trick worked well. While taking back Palak at home, I used to crack jokes and sing songs. Every day I had novel ideas. Actually, that made her classmates very curious. Because the classmates were very curious, that developed a fond bond between me and them. Every day, the closing time of school was fun time for all of us. Perhaps I was the father of all they dreamt of. Every day, her friends were dying to tell me something or the other. That helped Palak tremendously. She got true inclusion in her school. And that's how her confidence and fearlessness developed. Once we went to Ganpati Pule in Maharashtra when Palak was just 7. One group from Mumbai was already there with children aging from 10 to 15 years of age. And they were all communicating amongst themselves in English language. Palak wanted to join them. But because of the language, she waited for a while. Suddenly, she went and standing in the middle of them, she spoke, "I am Palak Piyush Vaidya." And everybody laughed and included her. This is what the confidence and fearlessness I am talking about. Her friends once informed me that Palak did not play in recess time in the grounds. So we revised our schedule and started playing more ground games. Mr. Anil Joshi once asked us to prepare the video on inclusive education as Palak's inclusion was in school was exemplary. I went to school without prior notification. On interviewing, everybody gave heart-touching and intuitive answers, but one girl brought tears in my eyes as well. She told, "I wish every class has a student like Palak." Palak is very caring, very loving. She keeps us all bonded. She loves us all equally and she is not biased. this is what she got from her school. I frequently told Pallas that I wanted to study with her in a class, and she would smilingly say, "Daddy, this is girls' school, boys not allowed," and she laughed. Occasionally, she cried in class, but her friends never informed me about this. As soon as we reached home, Nina could spot it immediately and would ask her tactfully and skillfully, "Pallas, you cried in boring class of social studies today, isn't it?" She would instantaneously answer, "No, mummy, not in SS class, but I cried in English class." And then she used to narrate the whole incidents to her. I always wondered how Nina would recognize it. To my question, she would smilingly tell me, "You need to be a mother for that." And I remembered the golden words, "Men are from Mars, women are from Venus." At times, I handled her very firmly, but she responded very well. We are partners in crime for so many things, me and Palak. We had our own language. I spoke the words and sentences in reverse language. And both of us became so expert in this reverse language, Nina and Palak could not catch.
Purvaj.
Nina and Purvaj, my eldest son, they could not catch our language, so they threatened us one day to give one chapati less for every reverse sentence spoken. Oh my God, that was a nightmare for me and Palak. But both of us are foodies. So we compromised our language to the food. But continued secretly.
The example of reverse language.
Yeah, I used to call Tavin Arbo to Bonvita. Tavin Arbo to Bonvita.
Bonvita, Tavin Arbo.
It is an example. Tavin Arbo to Bonvita. That's how we used to speak all languages, sentences
sentence.
Very speedily.
Yeah, Palak does this. At present also.
We are and we were experts in innocent conspiracy. During this season of sale, we insisted Nina and Purvesh to go for shopping. We were only interested in food corners. And what a time we had, 2 to 3 hours at coffee corners. My God, I still relish those moments. We have even one more language of science. Palak is never interested in watching movies. I used to show, but the interval time. Interval time was great for her. I used to show science for her, samosas, Frankie, and ice cream. She was ever ready. And it so happened gradually that no sooner did we plan for a movie, then she initiated showing science to me and were ready for the film. I took Palak to superstores. She had the habit of seeing all the packets, and gradually she learned to buy the things or purchase things according to schemes and discounts. Milo was never on the purchase list of Nina, but Palak convinced me and made it compulsory to buy, because every time either badminton racket, Tazo, or binoculars were free on it. Palak also used to go to a local vendor to buy household things. One day she came complaining, "Daddy, the shopkeeper did not give anything for free for 1 kg of sugar." Arey Baba, I had a very terrible time to explain that nobody in the world ever gets anything for free on bigger 1 kg of sugar. I am fond of doing drama and anchoring sessions. Since early childhood, both my children, they used to accompany in my sessions, practice sessions. And that is how naturally the qualities of a performer evolved in them. We had another language of Asma and Tasma in Gujarat. It is a very famous language. Suppose if I want to call Palak, I call her Pasmala Kasma. And she used to call me Das Baby Smi. So our interaction was so fast and so speedy, we frustrated many. And we enjoyed thoroughly, both of us. At times, when I saw Palak moodless, I used to sing songs with my own lyrics. As for example, once I sang, she was moodless. Palak to kyun udas ho gayi, aise fir kyun room mein baith gayi, and she would instantaneously join me and would sing. Kuch nahi hua hai mujhe daddy, aise hi baithi hoon main daddy. And we had, you know, jovial time together. We were back to smile. We have our own language of abbreviations. Suppose if I want to get caressed on my head, I would call MHF. In Gujarati, it means Matha Ma Hath Phir. The concept of laughing at jokes was more established due to this language, because if somebody would crack joke, I would say instantaneously, Palak, A-H-H, A-double-H means Ama Haswanu Hatu. You need to laugh. We have lot of abbreviations which we only understand. And one example, LOC, lips on cheeks, broad smile. NNOF, no nose on forehead. At times our children, you know, they do like that.
They don't so, like.
This language, abbreviation language, gave her support, warmth and confidence in public. Although we are so close since her childhood, we have never entered into zone of privacy of each other. That has built a strong concept in her regarding privacy. As I was a strong link between Nina and her school, Nina could plan formal studies for her, and according to the feedback given, and that resulted in optimal performance of Palak in her higher standards. I never told her about her limitations. I always expressed her abilities, and that's how that helped her to remain cool and calm even during her board exams. After 12th, when her nursing training started, I used to help her. I guided her wherever necessary, and at present she is a great helping hand. She handles all my OPDs, my OT, all my ward patients, and all are very happy. I am also very happy. When Palak is at home, she is just a daughter. When she is at the job, she is just an employee of mine. Having tight compartments must be the result of copying my attitude. We are going for a cycling trip next month to Italy. While practice sessions of cycling, I had a hard time handling her. Once, she resisted too much, just because the task given to her was 7 kilometers of cycling at a stretch, without interruption. She saw my persistence. I was very firm. She gazed my persistence and then started laughing and started singing, Bapu sehat ke liye tu to hanikarak hai. And she laughed and laughed. This has never happened for the first time. Or humor emerges in her crisis and she deals with it very well. We have been fortunate enough to transfer our mantra of life, enjoy when it is choice, equally enjoy when it is a compulsion. While playing, I don't allow her to win all the time. We are fond of singing and do karaoke, and that has helped her in rhythmic singing.
Just one more minute.
I'll just finish it off. While listening to music, I usually tap my fingers like drums. And Palak one day started playing drum in rhythmic manner, tak dina din tak. I was surprised, and she even informed us about the tribal way of drumming. Tamba pitar, tinno bangar, gamna patel, jakta rejo, devki nandan, sokte rame, tak dina din tak, tak dina din tak. We all were stunned. She knew it. Her sense of humor developed naturally. She cracks jokes and one-liners very smartly, and I just love it. The way she continues to amaze us daily, I have my own doubts of, regarding literature quoting children with DS not having logical and reasoning capabilities. We have a special world of ours. We crack jokes, we pull legs, and we point out to each other, me and Palak. But we enjoy it. We are popularly known as Tom and Jerry in our family. But let me tell you that Tom and Jerry alone cannot entertain effectively. It is the collective effort of the story writer, the Almighty God, the background score and musician, my elder son Purvaj, editor, screenplay writer and director, my wife Meena, production house, my in-laws Pandyas, and recently the special effects are given by my daughter-in-law Chandani. With fun, frolic, festivity, traveling, education and training, life is beautiful with my family. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Vaidya. I don't think I can match his ability to speak at all. I think we need some training lessons for him. Excellent presentation, and thank you very much. So we move on to the next speaker, Mr. Sardar Razak.